We'll be doing questions regarding pulley systems, which is a subset of the topic regarding forces. The first question we'll tackle is a single pulley system question. So, find the magnitude and direction of the acceleration of the weight in the following pulley system on the right. So, firstly, we'll draw the free body diagram for this system. So, on the 4 kg weight, there'll be a net force acting down of 4g and a tension acting up equals to T. The 6 kg weight will similarly be the same. Now, because it's a single pulley system, we can find the overall acceleration of the whole system, which will simply be the total net force downwards if we treat this whole thing as one system. And that will give us F net will be equivalent to 2g, which is the 6 kg minus the 4 kg, which will be equivalent to 10A, because the total mass of the system is 10, which is 6 plus 4. Therefore, we can get that A is equivalent to 0.2g. Now, we'll have to find the tension of the system. To do so, we'll simply take out any of the free body diagrams and analyze it. We'll take reference from the 6 kg one. So, the 6 kg pulley will obviously be the one, I mean, the 6 kg weight will be moving downwards. Therefore, 6g minus T will be equal to 6A. Since we found out that A is equivalent to 0.2g, we simply rewrite this as 6g minus t is equivalent to 1.2g, which will therefore tell us that t is equivalent to 4.8g. And we are done with the question. Basically, for this type of questions, we will simply draw the free body diagram, find the overall acceleration, and then subsequently find the tension in the string. As for our next question, it will be regarding a system of three pulleys. So, in this question, there are three pulleys A, B, and C, each attached with a 7 kg, 1 kg, and 5 kg weight respectively. Calculate the magnitude and direction of the acceleration of each of the weights. So, firstly, when we see this type of question, we will simply assign an arbitrary direction for the acceleration first. It can either be up and down, and the final value, if it's negative or positive, would tell us if it is in actuality up or down. So, from my instincts, I believe that the 7 kg pulley will move down. We will call this A1. The 5 kg pulley will also move down. We'll call this A2. And the 1 kg pulley will therefore move up, and its acceleration will be A1 plus A2. The 1 kg pulley accelerates at A1 plus A2 because the length of the string is a constant, and for the length of the string to remain constant, the middle pulley must be moving at the acceleration of both of the left and the right pulley in order to ensure that the total length of the string is constant throughout. Now, we will start drawing the free body diagram of each of the individual pulleys. So, firstly, we'll address the 7 kg pulley. On the 7 kg pulley, there's a force acting downwards of 7g, and there's a force acting upwards equals to tension. Next, going on to the 1 kg pulley, there's a force acting downwards of 1g and a combined force acting upwards of tension plus tension, which is 2t, because there are two strings attached to pulley B. On to the third weight, there's a force acting downwards of 5g and a subsequent tension acting upwards of 1t. Now we will simply write three equations. So, since the acceleration is going downwards for our 7 kg pulley, the net force would be the weight minus tension. 7g minus T will be equivalent to M, which will be 7 in this case, A, which will be A1. And this is our first equation. For our 1 kg mass, since it is going upwards, the tension is more than the weight. So, the net force would be 2T minus G is equivalent to A1 plus A2. This will be our second equation. For the third pulley, since the net force will be acting downwards due to our acceleration being assumed to be downwards, it will be once again 5g minus t is equivalent to 5a2. Now, we have three unknowns, which will be t, a1, and a2. And we have three equations. So, by simultaneously solving these equations with our calculator, we'll get the value of each of these, which turns out to be A1 will be equivalent to 0.681g, A2 is equivalent to 0.553g, and the tension is equivalent to 2.23t, I mean g. And this is how you solve a system with three pulleys. Now, we can further appreciate these answers. So A1 will be moving downwards. Therefore, because it's positive, so the actual fact, A1, which is the first pulley of the 7kg, will be moving downwards at 0.681g. B, which will be a combination of A1 and A2, and since it is still positive, means that it's actually moving upwards. So A2, which is the 1kg pulley, will be moving upwards at a speed of A1 plus A2, which will be 1.234g. Subsequently, the third pulley is moving downwards at 0.553g. As we can see, the first and the third pulley are moving down at their respective speeds, which is counteracted by the middle pulley moving up at this speed to ensure that the length of the string remains constant. And that is what I meant at the start when I said B must be moving at A1 plus A2. Lastly, we will be doing a question regarding a pulley that is in static equilibrium. So, given that the pulley on the right is in static equilibrium, find the mass of the unknown weight. Firstly, we will establish that the different strings are labeled by the different colors. Now, we will draw the free body diagram. So, on the 5kg mass, there will be obviously the weight acting downwards, which will be 5g, and the tension acting upwards, which will be equivalent to T. Now, moving on to the second pulley, since it's a similar blue string, the tension here will also be T, and the tension here will still be T. Since this system is in static equilibrium, it means that the downwards force must be equal to the upwards force on every single pulley. Therefore, there's a 2T tension acting downwards with respect to this pulley, let's just call it B, we'll label all the pulleys. And therefore, we establish that in the red string, the tension is equal to 2T. Now that we look at pulley C, we'll see that there will be a 2T tension acting upwards here, and a 2T tension acting upwards here, which will therefore tell us that the yellow string has a tension of 4T, which will subsequently tell us that if we look at pulley D, there's a 4T tension acting upwards here, and a 4T tension acting upwards here. Lastly, there's an X amount of weight acting downwards from here. Now, this is simply, since it's in static equilibrium, it means that T, the first T it is equivalent to 5G. For our last unknown weight, we have a total of 8T acting on it, and there's a total of XGs going downwards, and it's equal because it's not moving. So this is equivalent to XG. So since T equals to 5G, 8T will be equivalent to 40G. It's equivalent to XG, which will tell us that the mass of the unknown weight X is equivalent to 40kg. Thank you for watching this video, and do comment down below if you have anything you do not understand.